I will always do you.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. I wanted to make like a short quick video since I am on a relaxed stretch at the moment. So I wanted to make a short video on, you know, how to better stretch your relaxer if you're kind of struggling on, you know, stretching your relaxer. So I've always wanted to stretch my relaxer. It's gonna be about 6 months since I've been stretching my relaxer. So I just wanted to give you guys a few tips and pointers on how to stretch out your relaxer to make it more manageable and more easier for you to stretch. So I wanted to give you guys about 5 tips to kind of make it short. And my number one tip that I want to give you guys is to be patient when you are stretching out your relaxer. Stretching out your relaxer sometimes could be difficult, could sometimes be, you know, a pain, you know, knowing that your hair is transforming to, like, you're dealing with your new growth and you're dealing with your already relaxed hair. Sometimes it could be, you know, a bit tough for you to manage. Devoting yourself, you know, to properly taking care of your hair. Like, let's say if it's a wash day, you know, devote yourself. Take the day to, you know, treat your hair the way it needs to be treated. Be patient with your hair. Because, you know, patient is key. Patient is key when it comes to better managing your hair and to having strong and healthy hair. So that's my number one tip of when it comes to stretching your relaxer. My number two tip, I would say, is always keep your hair moisturized. What I mean about always keep,
I love my baby, that's my baby. I will sleep my baby right. Hold my baby tight. Baby, no.
For me, I moisturize my hair. I do like a deep conditioning treatment for my hair for twice a week. I do that. So Mondays and Wednesdays will be the days that I will do a deep conditioning with a moisturizing conditioner with my hair. I would either cold wash it, or if it's a wash day for me, I would also deep condition my hair. So that is very, very, very important into stretching out your relaxer, is keeping your hair moisturized, because you're dealing with two different types of textures. The textures are the ones that your hair is already relaxed texture and the new growth texture. So you have to properly know how to keep those two moisturized. You know, think of it as if you have a long day out, you're thirsty, the sun is out, your mouth is feeling extremely, extremely thirsty. So what is the first thing that's in your mind? You want a glass of water, a fresh, cold glass of water to drink. So I would say think of your hair being that way. If your hair does not get the moisture that it needs, I can guarantee you that it's going to be dry, it's going to be rough, and it's going to be hard to manage. So always keep your hair moisturized. And some of the things that I use to keep my hair moisturized when I am moisturizing my hair or doing a deep conditioning, I normally like to use my Too Chic by Giovanni, my Ultra Mist Conditioner by Giovanni. I love this conditioner. It is one of my staple products, I can honestly say. And I would also use my Caracare, but I'm actually out of that conditioner right now. But for the moment, I try to use that conditioner. And you could also use a cheapy conditioner to, you know, do your cold washes with to keep your hair moisturized. Because you don't necessarily have to use a conditioner that costs you about $10 into keeping your hair moisturized. And another thing I use the Daily Deep Conditioner. I also use that as well. Trying to see if you guys could see it. You guys could see it right here. And then if I want to do a deep conditioning, like a deep conditioning for the day, I will use my the Shea Moisture Deep Treatment Mask. All these products I'm showing you are really great into helping your hair stay moisturized the time that you are trying to relax it. I would say the fourth one is use a wide tooth comb when combing your hair. Try to mostly finger comb your hair, and if you can't finger comb your hair, then that being said is that you need to use a wide tooth comb. Do not use, you know, any other combs other than your wide tooth comb. So make a wide tooth comb your best friend. I actually have two wide tooth combs that I use. I use these two. I use this when my hair is wet, and I use this when my hair is dry. So use a wide tooth comb. Make these two your best friend, because you could rip your hair out if you're using any regular kind of comb, and you don't want that. You don't want to be ripping your hair out and your hair starts breaking. So it's always good to use a wide tooth comb, because it makes it manageable for you to comb through your hair. And then the fifth one I would say is always do a protective styling. When I'm in a protective styling, like let's say for this sew-in that I have in my hair right now. So I decided to put a sew-in in my hair because I feel like it's less manipulating my hair. I'm not touching my hair. I'm giving my hair a break and I'm letting that new growth kick in. So that's one of the main reasons why I got this sew-in. Or other protective style that you could do is a bun. I do buns a lot in my hair when I am doing protective hairstyling. So there are plenty of protective hairstyling that you can do that can help you get through your stretch. So always do protective hairstyling. And another thing too, always moisturize and seal your hair. What I use to moisturize and seal my hair, I use the Triple Moisture Silk Touch Leave-In Cream. I use that to moisturize and seal my hair every night. I would use it with my and seal it with my Jamaican black castor oil, or I would seal it with my coconut oil. So always moisturize and seal your hair. Okay, so I wanted to give you guys with this few tips on how to stretch out your relaxer. So one is being patient. Two is always moisturizing your hair, keeping your hair moisturized, whether it's cold washing, deep conditioning your hair, washing your hair with a sulfate-free shampoo, like something like this that I use to wash my hair. Four is using a wide tooth comb or finger combing your hair. And then five is always do a protective hairstyle in your hair that will cause you to less manipulate your hair. Okay, so I wanted to leave you guys with this. Thank you so much again for tuning in. I really do appreciate the ones who come by and watch my channel and the ones who subscribe. So please don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe, and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks again for watching. Have a great day, you guys. Be blessed.